Are you guys ready for this?
Hey, I heard you are a wild one.
What do you think? Ooh. At this time, put your hands together for the one, the only, David Tutera.
Show me how you do. I wanna shut
down. Are you ready to have some fun tonight? My journey, it's kind of interesting. I love telling this story now because the story is kind of crazy. So I started the singing telegram company in Larchmont, New York, and one day a woman came in my store who had been standing outside in line at the movie theater next door, and she came in and said, "Listen, I'd like to meet the owner." And I said, "Absolutely, I'm the owner." And she goes, "Would you decorate my son's bar mitzvah just like you decorated the window?" And I was like, "Absolutely." And then she left, and I called the one Jewish person I knew, and I said, "What the hell's a bar mitzvah?"
Get loose out the bottle. We all get fit in again tomorrow. Gotta break rules, cause that's the motto. Club shut down 100 supermodels.
Life is a journey. Life is about dreaming. Life is about taking chances. I wouldn't be able to be here where I'm doing what I do. There are gonna be many different dreams given away tonight. I don't know. All I can say is you better know the seat you're in, because I'm going to be calling selectively a seat. All right, well, here's a dream. So this dream, you're going to be coming up, chatting with me for a couple minutes, and then you're going to get whisked away backstage to the makeover room. Oh, my gosh. Uh-huh. And you're going to have a complete makeover from head to toe. And you're actually, let's see, you're gonna have a makeup artist take care of you. If you're at table 334 and your seat is number 8, come up and see me. Where are you?
This is how I roll. Animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big bra. And like Bruce Lee, I got the clout. Yeah.
How are you? Okay, so are you ready for this?
Yes.
Okay, so you're gonna go backstage.
Okay.
And there's a team of experts back there. They're gonna make, I mean, you already are magnificent and beautiful. And oh my gosh, are you a bride?
Yes.
So maybe this, we'll consider this like her trial, like I tell girls to do. You need a trial before you have your wedding. So go back, relax. You know, we're gonna be checking in on you throughout the whole show.
Okay.
So you're gonna be coming up on the screens, and I wanna see how you're looking and how the girls in the back are doing. And you're gonna step back out here in style, and I know you're gonna look gorgeous. You gotta hear what's gonna be won. Ready? Gotta lower the music for this one, Casey. You're going to win a dream getaway. Here's the deal. This clock right here is gonna go 3 minutes and down. You have 3 minutes to take the junk that's in the laundry basket, including toilet paper, tissue, newspapers, tape, whatever junk is in them, you all the same. You have 3 minutes to create a beautiful piece of fashion on the mannequins. And when you're done, I'm not judging you. They're gonna tell me who's the winner. You ready? Let's do it. Go, girls. And I move a little quicker.
I'm gonna pop some tags. Time is up, ladies.
Step away.
All right, let's see who won here tonight. Here we go. This time, really loud if you wanna see who's gonna win here tonight. Catherine? Catherine? Olga, who wants Olga to win? Marissa? High five to Marissa. Good job.
Well, it really, first of all, it's a great honor to be here this evening. It's an amazing event. It's great to celebrate with you guys. Very nice to meet you. My dream from about the age of 4 or 5 was that I wanted to move to America. And throughout my journey as a young woman, I knew I wanted to sing around the world. Even when we reach our goals, we have to keep fighting to create even the next step of the dream. So you asked me, you know, what is my dream now? And it really is to continue. I've done a lot of philanthropy work, and it's so important to keep inspiring not only the youth of today, but all generations, that we can do whatever we want to do in life. We have to take the practical steps to get there, and to reach out, you know, get the advice that we need and the support from friends and family.
I agree.
really,
it's important to be able to not set limitations on yourself.
Dream big, but work backwards and work out what practical steps I need to get from A to B.
Hold on a second, because I want to check on the makeover going on in the back. How is she doing? Can we see how she's doing? I peeked before. Yeah? Does she look good? You know, because I went back there. She looked really excited. She was relaxed. David. So we have a little surprise performance going on.
You got
right
a performance
now.
Right now.
Right?
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for a very talented young man. This is Carlos Santana's nephew, ladies and gentlemen, Adam Lasher.
The world was on fire, no one could save me but you. Strange what desires can make some foolish people do. I never dreamed I'd meet somebody like you. No, I never dreamed that I'd lose someone like you.
This is a boy who I would like to consider a new friend of mine, and I think you'll feel the same way. He's a very special four-year-old, and I think you'll be very inspired. So before I introduce you to him, watch this video and let me know if he moves you as much as he did in a beautiful way. Take a look.
We found out early on through an ultrasound that Joshua was going to be different.
We didn't have any expectation of any deformities or problems, and when we heard the news, we were coming in with the expectation of learning his gender, and then when we saw the actual pictures of his legs and realized that that what he had was actually genetic, that my husband had the same condition, I think it took a little bit of time for us to let it sink in because we had no expectation of that whatsoever.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my wonderful little friend Joshua and his mom and dad, Laura and Michael. Buddy.
Give him a high five.
High five. I have to tell you, Joshua, when I watched your video, I fell in love with you because not your disabilities, but most importantly, your spirit, your heart. You inspire all of us. Tell me a little bit about what are the hobbies you have? What are the things that you like to do?
I like to play around.
You do?
Very nice.
You have a lot of fun?
Yes.
Yes? What are some of the favorite things you like to do when you play around?
Play on my jungle gym outside.
Awesome. So when you watch yourself on television, because you know I saw you on Fox News, it was awesome to watch you. Like, is it kind of cool to see yourself on TV?
Yes.
Yeah? Laura, you know, hearing your story and getting a chance to meet you backstage was really fantastic. I get a question asked to me all the time. Do you stay in touch with the girls that have been on my show? The answer is yes and no. But tonight, I thought we'd bring two brides back for you to see where they are now. And, two that have remained friends, and they're really wonderful girls. Come on out! You may or may not recognize one of them.
Or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Took my life from negative to positive. I just want you to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life.
We had challenges with our wonderful bride and groom. Not our bride and groom, but families that surrounded Shirley. And I think there's been some changes in your life. First of all, you're obviously very pregnant right now.
I just ate a lot backstage.
Oh, yeah.
I remember riding in to the show, and I can remember sitting on the couch and telling Eddie, I'm going to ride in. I'm so excited. And he's like, don't get too excited, please. And we heard back from the show the very next day, and I was able to meet David, and it was just an incredible adventure.
You know, the show goes on, and you know, who knows what'll happen in the future with it, but the reality is that with Shirley, dreams come true. Her families are now melded together, and she's about to have a baby. When do you do?
July 4th.
Oh my gosh. And Kim and Eddie's dreams came true because here you are healthy and with two beautiful little boys. So I asked you to do what I always say to everybody else, is for you to continue to dream and to dream bigger.
My question is, what would you give as advice to a bride who likes to dream big but is on a tight budget?
If you have a wedding that tells your story of who you are, or any celebration for that matter, that's your dream that comes true. Not the amount of money you think you don't have or do have, because it has nothing to do with the bottom line. It has to do with you guys. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. We're gonna bring out our dream makeover. Let's bring her out. Oh my gosh!
Yeah. Yeah. When I walk on by, girls be looking like fly. I pick to the beat, walking down the street and my new the freak. Yeah. This is how
so
I roll.
So what was that like in the back?
Oh, it was amazing.
Yes?
Yes.
And we got our final package. Ready? Oh, this is a biggie. Hold on, hold on. I gotta read this. Oh my gosh. The value of this package is $10,000. All right, so where's table 413? Seat number 10.
Wanna get mad. Birds all sing as if they knew.
Come on.
Today's the day we'll say I do, and we'll never be lonely anymore. Because we're going to the chapel.
Oh, hey. Oh my God, you okay? No, you okay? Deep breathe, breathe, breathe. She's breathing. Oh. This is what it's all about right here. Congratulations, honey.
Thank you so much.
You're very, 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 very welcome. Will you help me close the show?
Yes.
Come here. Come here. Let me give you this first. You all right, baby? This is why I love what I do. That is yours. I can't tell you what an absolute pleasure tonight has been to spend this entire evening with all of you. One of the most important things that I learned from my mom and my dad that I'm sharing with you beautiful, what's your first name?
Lisa.
Lisa, who's very emotional because she won this amazing package. It's not about the things that you win or the things that you do. It's about the dreams that you create and the dreams that you make happen. And the most important thing is that you always need to hope, you always need to live, and you always need to continue to dream bigger. And if I can share a little of that with all of you tonight, and you pass it on to every person that you know, that's what life's about, dreaming bigger and making your dreams come true. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for letting me spend my night with you. It's been an honor. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, another big round of applause for David Tutera.
Show me.